You're doing well, my friend. Yeah, you're like a radio disc jockey now. You're like transitioning, and
you just let me know when you guys are ready.
Yeah, that was really good.
All right, I think we're ready.
And keep an eye on that microphone for me, Scott.
Good morning and welcome back. This is Charles Musgrove with the Bean Team, and you are listening to Business Matters on Real Talk 93.3. Today we are jumping into a topic that is top of mind. This is new in the state of Florida. We're going to talk about cannabis in the workplace, the employer-employee relationship, just the impact that it has on that relationship. We've got federal law versus state law, a lot of conflict there. We're joined by Scott Callen of the Kullman Law Firm again. Scott, thank you so much for joining us. This is a juicy topic. This is one that I think a lot of people are going to find of interest. A lot of this is brand new. So this is not something that people have dealt with for years and years, at least in my experience. This is new. This is hot. So let's jump right into it. Let's frame it. Let's frame what that is between the employer relationship, what it means to the employee, the goods, the bads, the conflict.
Sure. Thanks for having me back again, Charles. Yeah, this is a very hot topic, a very trending topic, needs to be fleshed out for a lot of different employer-employee relationships, the law, legislature. There's a lot of different issues and relationships here, but let's do our best to get it going. So I talked about this topic as I call it marijuana or cannabis catch 22. On one hand, you know, if you do it this way, you might have problems. If you do it another way, you might have problems. There's not maybe a solution so much. But so let's talk about how we frame these. The employee side. So here, I'm just going to frame that along a personal story. A friend of mine's wife decides to start taking over-the-counter CBD oil. Like we were talking about on the break, you know, you can find it on Amazon, you can find it at convenience stores. It's prevalent, it's pervasive, it's widespread,
very common. Yeah. I've seen where it's going to be coming. If it's not there already, you can get it at Walmart, Target. So
yeah,
it's coming to a counter near you if it's not already there.
Exactly. So the question I have from her is simple. She's a good employee. Let me frame it that way. Good employee. She's not in some position that she's going to hurt somebody with an automobile, or she doesn't carry a gun to the workplace. And so she's not in some position where she's under the influence of alcohol or drugs. She's going to hurt somebody because of some dangerous piece of her job. But the reality is she takes the CBD oil and it helps her sleep. And that's a real testimony from her to me, in a sense of, she says, look, I've done a lot of these other drugs that are commonly prescribed, and I started taking CBD oil. No, I'm not with the CBD industry whatsoever. But my point about it is, in her mind, it really helped her get to sleep and solve a lot of medical issues. But the question she has for me is, Scott, can my employer fire me? And so she's stuck in a catch-22, in a sense, because it helps her from medicinal purposes. But at the same time, if she gets fired from her job, that might thwart her or deter her or stop her from using CBD oil.
Yeah, so that's got to be a common issue, though, because here she's taking an over-the-counter drug, and we're talking about CBD and not
cannabis,
medical marijuana.
Right.
But she's probably substituted that CBD for Xanax or some prescription.
Correct.
That has more adverse effects.
Yeah.
So now you've got that just creates a problem.
Yeah. So that's her perspective, and I had to be honest with her and tell her, yeah, there are some laws in place. You know, we can get more into it, but yes, there's a Florida medical marijuana statute that says you can take medical marijuana, but can the employer fire you? Yes, but, and we'll get into the buts. But that was her perspective, and that was real for her. Now, I represent a lot of companies, so let me tell you their perspective. Their perspective is, hey, What happens if the employee is taking medical marijuana and gets into an accident?
Right.
And I get sued because not just for selfish reasons or concern about their liability, but truly, like, what if they're out delivering something and they get into an accident and hurt somebody and they were, you know, using marijuana? What happens if their job performance starts to decline? What happens after 30, 40 years of government and public studies and information bulletins out there that saying drugs are no good, and now all of a sudden you're telling me I should allow drugs in the workplace? And so they're facing an issue of, what do I do as an employer? So the employers break up into basically three camps, Charles. There's the one employer who has a labor force issue, and that is, if I went to go test for marijuana, recreational or medical, I would not have a workforce.
Right. You may not be able to get employees to do the job.
Exactly. So, you know, that might be, I'm not trying to badmouth any particular industry, but you might see that.
That's real.
Yeah, that's a real issue. So, you know, that's...
Plus the way that a lot of the insurance laws, like workers' comp, they're set up to prevent employees from taking drugs and that causing the accident. So you've got issues there with the workers' comp laws. So that's an issue. And then we get into the discrimination. Those employees are taking either prescription drugs or they're taking cannabis, prescribed cannabis,
right,
for a health reason, for some reason.
Yeah. So that's a whole nother side of it. There's the side of, on one hand, I'm taking this drug, this medical prescribed drug, cannabis, so employers can stop that and say, no, that's still illegal under federal law, so you can get fired for it. On the other hand, what happens when the employee comes in and says, no, you really didn't fire me because of the cannabis usage. You fired me because I have cancer or post-traumatic stress or whatever the medical issue is. And my understanding of the medical marijuana laws, there's only certain enumerated kind of medical conditions that qualify, but you stick those conditions in with the disability discrimination laws that says you can't fire somebody because of a medical condition that rises to a disability. There's a catch-22. Are you firing the employee because
Scott,
of the pot, or are you firing up because of the cancer?
Yeah, man. Scott, I just see this makes my head spin, that you're going to have good employment contracts. You're going to have a good employment attorney to walk you through this, because a lot of this, I would think, is new ground. This stuff hasn't been fleshed out to a large extent yet.
Yeah, the answer is you'd probably get different opinions about that, whether it's been fleshed out or not. If I said it hasn't been, then you'd probably have 20 lawyers send you Facebook messages that say it has. But on the same time, in my view, laws evolve, these issues evolve. And so are there ancillary or other issues that we just don't know about, or how are we going to struggle with it? Yeah, those are, you know, courts and lawyers will grapple and fight about this issue. So, you know, just to get into it with, you know, in Florida, the answer is it clear that on one hand you can stop having employees use or be intoxicated with marijuana in the workplace? The answer is yes. There's a federal law that makes it a crime. There's state statute, Florida state statute, that says essentially employer doesn't have to accommodate the medical use of marijuana in any workplace or any employee while under the influence of marijuana. And this section does not create a cause of action against an employer for wrongful termination or wrongful discharge. So there'd be one camp that says it's pretty clear, but at the same time, again, there are probably gaps out there, you know.
Well, there's got to be extremes. You're going to have employer situations where they've not documented, there's not a clear distinction that the reason they're terminated is because of the medical marijuana use, or is it because of a disability, or them just wanting to.
Yeah, so where do you draw the line? That's the issue. So you've got one employee that takes, let's just say, Ritalin for attention deficit disorder, but that employee has maybe is accommodated, or the employer just doesn't ask, or you know, or some other drug. I don't know. It's Sudafed that,
right,
if you read the over-the-counter, says don't drive heavy machinery or something like that.
But yet, Sudafed's the one they ask you if they want your driver's license and everything else because
Yeah, it's easier to get alcohol than Sudafed these days.
I think it is.
But you can buy it at CVS, but are you going to fire somebody because they use pot but not Sudafed?
Right.
I mean, you see, it gets into
those. It's a dilemma.
Issues. Yeah, it really does.
So what is – I know there's – this is legal in the state of Florida, but it's not federally. So
– correct.
What is the overlap with the employment law? Is that primarily state-driven or is that federal-driven?
It's both, the answer to the question. So just basic employment law type claims, you can have federal claims and you can have state law claims. So as an employment law attorney, when I get a question from a client on this issue, I have to understand the federal laws and the state laws. And here, like we've been discussing, sometimes there's maybe there's some gaps or there's some conflicts. Or maybe the issues haven't been all completely resolved. So the answer is you have to look at both sides of it. Florida, again, has a statute that seems to suggest the majority opinion would you know, of experts and legal experts seem to say, hey, look, the Florida legislature dealt with this. It's still illegal under federal law. There's no duty to accommodate medical marijuana. There's no cause of action. So you'd get one group of attorneys that would say it's pretty clear. But I got to tell you, there's probably going to be issues that surface that just aren't answered yet.
If you're just joining us, you're listening to Business Matters. I'm Charles Musgrove, and you're listening to 93.3 Real Talk Radio. We're talking with Scott Callen about cannabis in the workplace, the effects of the employer-employee relationship. Scott, one of the items we've not touched on is what's the effect on personal injury lawsuits?
Yeah, great question there. So how's that framed in the personal injury context? So on one hand, you've got medical marijuana. It's allowed. The employee's taking it. Maybe the employer doesn't want to prohibit it. Maybe the employer takes the view of, hey, you're a secretary or you're a clerical person, and I'm okay with that. But what happens if the legal assistant or your assistant goes and gets you a sandwich because you're having some big conference meeting? And they're driving for work purposes. They get into an accident on a 15-minute errand, and I'm just exaggerating for the purpose of demonstration, but let's say they run into a bus or something and hurt a bunch of school kids. You know, but they have marijuana in their system.
Legal marijuana.
Legal marijuana.
They have a prescription for it.
Yeah, but it's still they're doing it in the scope of their job.
Right.
So under Florida law, usually employers are held liable for the acts of their employees done in the scope of their employment.
Right.
So, you know, there's that issue. I'm sure there's defenses to it, and defense attorneys will come up with some defense, but the plaintiff's attorneys will say, hey, maybe you should have tested and you didn't test. I mean, that's where it becomes an issue there.
Yeah, I can see that. The real, you started with the human story. This is the benefits of this are we all have personal stories where we know people that have benefited from the use of medical marijuana, and it makes a real difference in their life. We were just talking with a story of a friend that was a real story with his wife, that she was basically in her house. She couldn't get out because of the prescription drug she was taking. She got on medical marijuana, made a tremendous difference in her life, really gave her life back. So these are real issues that we're going to be facing more and more in the workplace. So now you get an employee that's able to work effectively, but they're taking medical marijuana, which is a federally illegal drug.
It's a real dilemma. Again, I think Florida's maybe a little bit more out in front of it than some other states, so I don't act like there's not laws that are addressing it, but there's no law that says you have to prohibit usage of marijuana by your employees too. So if an employer wants to do that, they can do it, but it's a real dilemma. So what do you do? Those are questions that I think have to be answered. I'd answer them with an attorney, just to be honest with you, because there are legal parameters here you want to deal with and understand. But every company, every employee situation, it might be a little bit different. So you want to understand you know, what industry are you in? How common is the usage? Does it really, are you really at risk from injuring others if you allow employees to use the marijuana? Maybe not so much. Are you at a competitive disadvantage if you don't allow it? You know, there's a bunch of issues that you should probably think through with an attorney, and just to make sure, how do you want to do it for your workplace as a company? Don't just take a one size fits all approach. If you want to go with the, I'm just not allowing it in the workplace, that's fine too, but let's make the assessment. And there can be situations that pop up even in the just say no, I'm not going to allow it, that you might need to work through and understand. It's not just that an employer can say no, it's a federal crime, so you're not allowed to use it. There might be other laws that pop up and they should evaluate the situation.
May need to evolve from that position.
Yeah.
What we didn't talk about, the effect on different states. So if you're an employer that has employees in different states, or they cross state lines,
right,
what happens in those situations? Do you see that as it going to be an issue?
For some of my clients, it is because I represent clients that they might have home base here in Tallahassee or Florida, corporate headquarters in Florida. But let's just say maybe they've got some employees out in Denver, or maybe they have somebody in Alabama, or, you know, you have to, or the Northeast or New York, or, you know, they work from home or something. You know, those are issues where you start to get into, you have to understand the other state laws to know, does the state regulate it where the employee is working? You need to understand, well, okay, if so, and there's maybe tighter restrictions on what, let's say an employer cannot fire an employee in one of these states. Well, does your handbook now conflict with that state law? So you have to make an assessment first about what states you're operating in. And then you need to make sure your policies are consistent, and maybe your policies can't address every situation. So then you have to keep your policies broad enough to make sure you can apply the policies for one state, and then for one employee in one state, and then for another employee in a different state.
Right. So it's like with employment law, you're going to have, the state has an impact on what that
it does,
what your employee manual should have and how you should treat your employees. So
absolutely,
to a large extent, you're going to have to be flexible of that and adjust that based on the medical marijuana laws in each state.
Yeah, you can either be flexible and broad, or you might have to be very state specific. It's like one of those credit applications where it says applying for credit in New Hampshire, don't give us this information. In New York, don't give us this information. In Kansas, we can't do this. You know, that they have all those footnotes at the bottom. You might, you know, either address it from a state by state or keep it broad enough so you can be malleable and flexible to the situation.
Right. Scott, tell us if, you know, you always want to get to, and what we do in our business, we want to inform business owners about best practices. So
right.
Have we gotten to the point where we know and we're advising people on what the best practices are regarding medical marijuana in the workplace?
I would say, yeah, I would say I have a general framework for best practices. Again, I think one of the best practices is right here at this show. And that's why this show is fantastic.
Thank you, Scott. Great plug.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the point is, you first have to understand there are a plethora of different issues that may come into it, other than you just reading something in the newspaper saying medical marijuana is allowed. But you might not know that employers can stop medical marijuana usage, or at least terminate somebody. And then likewise, you might know as an employer, I can say no, but you may not understand all the other employment ramifications. So my point about it is, it's an evolving area. Stay up to speed, understand, being able to identify the issues is a best practice in and of itself. Knowledge is your friend.
Right.
So that's why I think this is a really important topic for your audience. And so, you know, basically what I tell people is, know where the legal cops are on the legal highway. Nothing against, I'm very supportive of law enforcement, but my point about it is, you have to know there are landmines and pitfalls that are out there, and you don't want to violate and go over the speeding limit. And so you got to know where they are. So that's first and foremost.
So not knowing is not an excuse. That you don't get out of jail card free for not knowing.
Correct. And you may say the wrong thing. You may go to an employee and say, hey, look, we're firing you for marijuana usage. But you might have a supervisor that says, I don't think the company really cares about marijuana. I think they're really firing you because you have post-traumatic stress.
All right, Scott, let me throw this in at you. So we've talked about the medical marijuana. So I know that you read in the paper, I read in the paper here on podcasts, other states have gone to recreational marijuana.
Correct.
So that has got to just complicate that issue by 10 at least or 100. So now you've got not just a prescription drug in the state of Florida, but it's recreational. So
yep.
If you make the leap that may happen one day.
Correct.
Am I over exaggerating the complexities in the workplace?
No, not in the least bit. In Florida, to my knowledge, it hasn't been approved for recreational usage yet. So it's not here yet.
There is discussion, I think, that
it's
going to go on the ballot.
There's also newspaper articles I read about whether you're going to have state attorneys enforcing these laws because the federal laws, it says you can't use it, but we got laws that says you can, and then you got trace amounts of this and that. Anyhow, long story short, you almost default into recreational use if you don't enforce the laws, right? So here's the global answer. There's already states, like as you alluded to, there's already states that allow for it. In recreational use, in those states, they've had to come up with, are we going to say the federal law still controls, and so therefore employers, even though it's recreationally allowed, employers can still say it's illegal under federal law. I've seen a lot of opinions that say basically if it's still prohibited under federal law, then you can't force an employer to violate federal law. So you've got that. But then you've got other states that say can't fire an employee for the usage. You've got some states that say you can't fire an employee for off-duty conduct that is lawful. So you can't. In some states, you couldn't fire an employee for smoking if it's lawful. So yeah, there's just a host of issues. It goes on and on and on.
Man, there's there's a lot more coming with cannabis. So Scott, I feel like we had a good discussion today on the topic. There's more there to discuss. You've been listening to Business Matters on Real Talk 93.3. I'm Charles Musgrove with the Beam Team. Have a great day. Have a blessed week. Come back and listen to us next Sunday, 11:30 a.m. on Real Talk 93.3. Peace. Money, 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 money.